And welcome for the second class of this three-dimensional photoelasticity. So now in the last class we have discussed about the stress fringing technique and a scattered light polariscope. These two are very important question for this whatever the module 4. Okay, next is we are going to discuss about the scattered light methods. Okay, the scattered light methods of photoelasticity is based on a scattering characteristics of a wave of a light as it passes through the transparent medium. To illustrate this scattered phenomena, consider a wave of ordinary light propagated in z direction. Okay, so you can see this is the z direction of a light, and this is some of the ordinary light propagating along the z direction. Means it is just a plane which is of xy plane, which is considered in here. As shown in figure. However, the most of the material do not transmit light perfectly, and some scattering of the light occurs. If you consider any material, it will not transmit the light completely. Some amount of scattering is going to take place in this whatever the models. Okay, thus the scattering phenomena is going to be considered for the stress analysis. This scattering can be viewed as a secondary set of vibration. You can see the whatever the light which is come out here, it will be scattered at any direction. You can see that the different direction of scattering you can see in here at a different position. If you consider this position, it can be scattered at this direction, this direction, this direction. So any direction, it have infinite directions, so it can transmitted in any type of scattering can be happen in any direction. Okay. So this is called as a secondary set of vibration which are excited by a main wave and which propagate radial outward from the scattered source. Okay, it is moving outward. For a main wave of ordinary light propagated in z direction, the vibrations associated with the scattered light will all lie in a plane normal to z direction. Okay, whatever the vibration which are going to be in here propagating, so it will be normal, means it is in a perpendicular direction to the propagation of light in z direction, which is view along there which normal to the z axis. It can be viewed which is in a normal direction. So that is the scattering phenomena which is considered the scattered light method. For the purpose of photoelasticity, it may be assumed that a photoelastic material may has an infinite number of scattering source uniformly distributed through the material. Therefore, the incident light will scatter at every point and will produce a secondary source of plane polarized light which is propagated radially outward from the source. It is possible to use this polarized produced by the scattering of the light within a photoelastic model in the place of either the polarizer or the analyzer in the photoelastic polariscope. This utilization of scattered light, which is equivalent locating a polarizer or an analyzer in the interior of the model, provides an approach to generally three-dimensional problems. Since either the polarizer or analyzer can be optically positioned at arbitrary planes in the photoelastic model, stress information can be obtained without stress freezing or slicing of the model. The scattered light method which you are going to see in here, there is no slicing can be considered. Means if you want to determine stress directly on the model, which was without making any slicing. In the stress freezing method, we are going to make the slicing of the model and we will check the stress at the particular part of the model. But in here, what we do in the scattered light method, we just pass the light, and wherever we require, if you want to stress at this point, we will mount the whatever the camera normal to this direction. What happens at this point, you can see the vibration which is coming out of this model, it will be captured. Okay, this vibrations are nothing but it is plane, it is polarized light. Polarized light is going to be going to make the inclination with maybe with the principal stresses which are present in the model. So that inclination is considered, and that whatever the image which is obtained at here can be captured in the camera or viewed through that. Okay, so that phenomena is helpful. So if you want to stress at this in a different direction, if you want it here, you can take this direction. If you want it here, you can take this direction. So any point of this line, any point of this line of light, you can measure stress. Okay, that is the advantage of this scattered method. So in the conventional method, it is not possible. Even at the stress physics method, if you have to take the slicing of that point, you have to make the stress measurement in a conventional stress polariscope. So in here, it is one of the advantage in here. Okay, next move on to the scattered light as an interior polarizer. So the model itself acts as a polarizer. So in here, you can see this is the light. It is coming from this direction, and you can see the light is vibrating in many directions. In many direction, whatever the arrow mark is shown, so it represents the vibration in many direction. The light which enters at a point P. So this is the incident beam of ordinary light which is enters the model at the point P. So when it enters the point P, it will travel from P to Q. Okay. So there is all possibility that the whatever the light is going to be polarized at each point of travel from point P to Q. So what happens when the whatever the light travels, it is going to make the polarization, and this polarizations lights are having a potential to merge with the axis of secondary principal. So first it is going to merge with the primary principal stress. But if you are seeing in the perpendicular direction to the incident light, so you will find the secondary principal stress. So at the point of Q, if you consider the light is going to be scattered, and that scattered light which is considered at the point Q is going to merge with the principal stresses. But in here, we are considering the scattered light, we are considering the secondary principal stress. So that's why we are going to take it as sigma 1 dash and sigma 2 dash at the point R. So from Q to R, whatever the light which is moving from Q to R, which is scattered light, it is going to make some phase difference. Okay, so at the point of Q, the Q, the sigma 2 dash and sigma 1 dash are somewhat having a different vibration phase. At R, it having some phase difference. What happens, this whatever the phase difference is considered as average of this whatever the secondary principal stress. So this secondary principal stress average is going to be, our phase is going to be determined by providing an analyzer between the point R and the camera. So this analyzer, what it's going to make, whatever the phase difference which is present at this movement from Q to R can be analyzed in the analyzer, and whatever the viewing, whatever the image which is going to be captured through the camera. So like that, this whatever the scattered light polarizer, means scattered light as an interior polarizer, is going to be considered. So just shift the point of incident beam of light. So you can see the light is shifted to P to P dash, and you can see the light is now at the Q dash. The light is scattering at the point of Q dash. So what happens? There is a delta H difference you are going to observe in here. So what happens? So at a delta H difference, it again having the phase difference of delta H, which is going to be considered for the analysis, and we are going to measure from Q dash to R. Whatever the amount of phase which is observed, and that average is going to be considered. And that average is going to be considered, and that phase difference is going to be determined by the analyzer. Similarly, the whatever the amount of stress is going to be measured. So like that, you can easily shifting the incident light from one point to another, you can easily measure the point of stress at another point. So like that, it is the one of the phenomena that can be helpful for the determination of stress in the three-dimensional photoelasticity. You can see the same thing is given in here. Consider a first light scattered from the interior point Q in the model. If the model is stressed, the polarized light scattered from point Q is resolved into two components along the direction of secondary principal stress, sigma 1 dash and sigma 2 dash. As the light propagates outward over the distance QR, a phase difference develops between two components. There is a phase difference. This phase difference can be measured by inserting an analyzer between point R and the camera. In this instant, we will get this equation. That is the this is NR is the fringe number, NQR, and it can be resolved by H by sigma f. H is the thickness of the model, and sigma f it is considered as the fringe value, and sigma 1 dash and sigma 2 dash the secondary principal stress. It will be considered average, not just one point. It will be considered average, where that is the average value of sigma 1 dash and sigma 2 dash over the distance of QR. So that will be considered in here. So this is all about the this is all about the scattered light as interior polarizer. Next we move on to the next part of this scattered light. It is the scattered light as interior analyzer. You can see in the earlier we just having on the one whatever the incident light which is falling on the model, there is no extra polarizer is provided at the entrance. The light is normal light when it is going to fall, but in here you can see the incident beam of plane with a polarized light. Means it is a beam of light which is polarized at here. Okay, so at entrance only it is polarized, and you can see this is the polarizer which make it polarizing. It will make the polarization of the light. So this light is falling on the model which is already polarized. When it is fall on this point P, it will get scatters. It will get scatters, and this point of P is taken as the analyzer. Since this analyzer at the point of point P, it is going to be scatters, and it can make the inclination with the secondary principal stress sigma 1 dash and sigma 2 dash. So this is the act as a analyzer. So when this light is moving from P to Q, it will move from P to Q. So this sigma 1 dash and sigma 2 dash, which is at a having some phase of vibration, when it reaches Q, it will catch up some additional retardation. So it will have some retardation from here to here. This additional retardation is going to be taken at this point Q, and it will be measured and it will be observed from the direction Q to C. Okay, if you see here, at this point R, you can observe this whatever the scattered light retardation, and it will be observed from the point C. When the light enters some more distance at Q to Q dash, it's also having some catches the some additional retardation from Q to Q dash, and it will be seen from the camera, and it will be calculated by using some type of formulas. Okay, this distance from Q to Q dash is taken as delta H, means that is the delta H is the amount of retardation is observed, and that will be considered in here. The scattered light source, so this is in this type we are going to make the scattered light as an interior analyzer. Means the light model itself act as an analyzer. The polarized light is going to be fall on the model. So this analyzer effect is going to be observed from the perpendicular direction. Okay, the scattered source located at point P act as an analyzer. Since the scattered light is polarized, the resulting image observed along the QC will be intensity depends upon the relative retardation acquired over the path PQ. If the line observation is moved to Q dash C dash, the relative retardation varies depending upon the additional retardation acquired over the distance Q Q dash. Since Q Q dash is equal to delta H, means that is the distance, and the additional retardation acquired over the distance delta H is delta N. The ratio delta N by delta H is the space rate of formation of retardation in successive plane normal to the incident light beam of light sheet. The ratio delta N by delta H is related to difference in secondary principal stress sigma 1 dash minus sigma 2 dash lying in the plane normal to the incident light. This is the formula which is going to be used for the calculation in the at the scattered light phenomena. Sigma 1 dash minus sigma 2 dash average delta H at the distance, which is equal to delta N by delta H into sigma F. Okay, so this is the formula which is used for to determine the scattered light phenomena in the interior analyzer. So this is all about the scattered light as a polarizer and scattered light as a interior analyzer. So this is also important topics in this whatever this module 4, and this is all very important. You can easily understand, it's a very simple topics. Okay, with this we'll complete this whatever the module 4. Thank you, students. If you have any queries, you can contact me through whatever the mails, or you can contact through my contact number. Okay, thank you.